Dear students, now we are going to discuss a D dihybrid cross, dihybrid cross B by Morgan. Okay, so dihybrid cross B. A completed. Now we are within B dihybrid cross. Dihybrid cross B in Drosophila. Okay, so now what about our parents? Okay, so first one, female parent, Drosophila melanogaster. So this one female, this one male, double homozygous double recessive double dominant. So what about phenotype of a female concerned one, that is with recessive traits? So that is a white eye color is white, and miniature means small, wing size. Okay, so what about a female phenotype out of eye color and wing size? Okay, so color of the eye and the size of the wing. White eye, miniature means small winged one, crossed with the given one is wild means here brown. Wait, red eye, red eye, normal wing means large wing, red eye. Okay, so eye based character, that is the color of the eye, that is one character. Next, size of the wing, small, large. Two characters. Okay. One is a eye color. Second one is a size of the wing. Contrasting traits. White, red, one pair. Miniature, small, second pair. Okay. So how many genes? Here also two genes. Regulating two characters. Each character with a one pair of contrasting trait. Okay. So now what about the genotypes of these two individuals? So female means compulsory X chromosome with alleles of a concerned gene. So take a W. Use more gap between these two. And W M. If you observe A and B crosses at a glance, definitely you can understand what is the difference between the distance, the difference between Y and W and M here. Okay, the distance between Y and W, there is very less. Yeah, distance is more. Notice it. Okay. So crossed with a male with X chromosome. W, M. There is no difference so far. Make the difference. Here sign superscript is a plus, plus. Recessive alleles, dominant alleles. So this one is a double homozygous. So how to write genotype of this one? W, W, M, M. And this one is a Y chromosome. Okay, so here we can write in two ways. W, M, M plus R, W, M, oblique plus, plus also. Both are correct. Okay, right? So meiosis completed. Type of meiosis, don't forget that one, meiosis. Gametic meiosis. Meiogametes are produced. These are the basic parents. Parents. Okay, so now, meiosis, meiosis. Here also meiosis. So always crossing over is in between X, X chromosomes only in this case. There is no crossing over between X and Y chromosomes. Reason, on Y chromosome, alleles are concerned, genes are absent. So don't take any crossing over, but meiosis possible. Here crossing over between XX. Even after crossing over, there will be no change. Reason, here crossing over is in between W and M. Here no crossing over between W and M. Reason, Y is not involved in crossing over. In the case of A cross, crossing over was in between Y and W. Y plus and W plus. Again, we will discuss crossing over between concerned genes after completion of a B dihybrid cross. So now, what about the number of kinds of gametes from female X chromosome with W and M? That is one kind of gamete. So on behalf of a female, here also, what about the number of kinds of gametes possible? Only one kind of gamete. So gametes. G, I am using gametes. And because of segregation, X separated, Y separated. Here also segregation, X separated, Y separated. How many kinds of gametes? Only one. Here how many kinds? X into one kind of gamete, Y into another kind. As T is alleles. W, M plus. Okay, so gamete with X chromosome, gamete with Y chromosome. Now, what about the number of kinds of gametes on behalf of a male? Two kinds. Okay, right? Now, fertilization between these gametes. So, first one, decide the female first. Okay? On behalf of a male, a gamete with X chromosome is important. And definitely from female X chromosome only. Okay, so take those chromosomes here. X chromosome coming from male and female. So W plus M plus W M. So this one is a female. XX means definitely female. So this one is a F1 female. What about the phenotype of this one? Similar to the phenotype of male or not? Now it is with a red eye. Red eye, normal wing. Means wild. Wild one. Here also take wild one, wild. Okay, next. Okay, so compulsory you have to take a Y chromosome. Reason on behalf of a female, only Y, X chromosome. So X chromosome coming from female and Y chromosome coming from the male. And alleles W and M, recessive. Double homozygous, double dominant female. Double homozygous, double recessive male. Copy this one here. So this one, female. and this one male, with what type of phenotype? Female phenotype. White eye and miniature, small wing. Miniature wing. Okay, right? Now, cross fetlation. Your fetlation is a cross fetlation between two individuals. Compulsory two mating types are present, male and female. What is the sexuality of a Drosophila dioecious or not? Compulsory, two parents required. Compulsory, two mandatory. So now cross fetlation between F1 female and male. So here how to take out the gamete is very, very important. Without that, you can't understand the flowchart given in your textbook. Now take this one here. Okay. So F1 female intercrossed with F1 male. Take this genotype here. X chromosome with W plus M plus W M. This one X chromosome with W M and Y chromosome. Okay, so now meiosis, gametic meiosis. Now on behalf of a female, what about the number of kinds of gametes? First one, no crossing over or no genetic recombinations, without genetic recombinations. No genetic recombination. Crossing over failed. There is no crossing over between W plus and M plus. Okay, parental gametes only. What are the gametes? Okay, so first gamete is with the X chromosome, this one also. M plus W M. These are the parental gametes only, not the recombinant gametes. Parental gamete. One, if you go back, you'll get it. Parental gametes here. And the second one, crossing over occurred and the genetic recombinations happened with the genetic recombinations. It's genetically recombined. What is that? Genetical recombination. So take that one here. Chromosome, X chromosome 1, 2. M plus M. Okay, so here crossing over between W and M. Cut. Now move W plus here and W here. The crossing over happened between W and M genes. Okay, so recombined. Chromosomes with recombinations. So if it is shifted there between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes, here what about the number of kinds of gametes from this one? Okay, so gamete 1 with a X chromosome, next one X chromosome with W plus, okay, and M, W, M plus. Okay, so one recessive allele, one dominant allele. Here also same. Now, how many kinds of gametes? 1, 2, 3, 4. Of which 2 are the parental type, 2 are the recombinant gametes, like a dihybrid cross. Now, from this one, male, no crossing over between Y chromosome and X chromosome. So here, take a 2 kinds of gametes only, X chromosome, Y chromosome, W, M, this is one kind, Y chromosome, one kind, 2 kinds. Now, fetalization between these, okay, right? So now, what about F2? F2, male. First, take male according to textbook. Okay, wait. Male and a female you have to. Okay, so to decide sexuality of male, one chromosome must be Y. Take this one, fill it first. So male gamete with Y chromosome, sorry. Male gamete with Y chromosome. Now remaining 50%. Okay, here, 25. Okay, right? In this case, 50% involvement must be from the female or not. So now take a female gametes one by one. 1, 2, 3, 4, one by one. First one, parental gamete with W plus EM plus. Parental gamete with WEM. And this one, recombinant gamete, W plus M. X chromosome WM plus. Now, what about the phenotype of all these things? So, 1, 2, this row, parental combinations only. This one, non-parental combination. Non-parental means phenotypic recombinants. Go, what about the phenotype of this one? Come back here. Red normal means large wing. This one, white miniature. This one, red eye miniature wing. Next, white eye large wing. So that is about male F2, female F2. So here we should not use a Y chromosome compulsory on behalf of male. The remaining one is X chromosome. So now use a gametes coming from male with X chromosome with what type of alleles? Non-recombinant genes only. WM. Always maintain more distance between W and M. So contribution of a male completed, now female. As it is a 1, 2, 3, paste them there. X chromosome coming from female gamete, W plus M plus X chromosome from female gamete with WM, X chromosome coming from female with a recombinant genes, W plus M, WM plus. Okay, so parental gene combinations, non-parental combinations means phenotypic recombinants. Now, what about the percentage of a percentage? Parental percentage and recombinants here. Recombinants and parental percentage. So it is around 62.8. And 36 or 37.2. Yeah, 37.2%. Okay, right? Now, what about a percentage of parents here? Parental combinations, 62.8. Recombinants, 37.2. Now, we have to compare this percentage with the A dihybrid cross. In the A dihybrid cross, what about the percentage of parental? Parental percentage, 98.7. Recombinants, 1.3. Okay, right? Now, what about the conclusion made by Morgan is very, very important. Is it clear? So here, very, very important thing is how to take out the gamete. Next, distance between genes present on the same chromosome. Now, what about conclusions made by Morgan? Okay, what was the objective of Morgan? Experimental verification of a chromosomal theory of inheritance. And what he traced out? Variations caused during sexual reproduction. And after consolidation of experiments, what he discovered, that is very, very important. We will see that one. Okay, is it clear? So here, remember, percentage of parents and phenotypic recombinant. That part is very, very important. Otherwise, there is no meaning for A and B crosses. So now, what about the conclusions made by T.H. Morgan and his co-workers, collectively workers? Student also worked. We'll see that one later. So conclusion, Morgan conclusion. The conclusion of Morgan was, he coined two terms. One is linkage and recombination. Linkage and recombination. So after completion of A and B dihybrid crosses in Drosophila, he consolidated both. And what he traced out, what he discovered, first one, linkage. Take linkage, first one. The term linkage was coined by Morgan only. What is linkage? And we will see linkage groups later, not now. What is a linkage? Linkage means, according to Morgan, physical association of genes, certain number of genes. Genes, here I'm taking two genes. What are those two genes? We will see. Two genes. Here, two genes he studied. Two genes. What are they? Y and W genes. Y and W genes. Okay. So, physical association of any two genes, not only these two. So, physical association of two genes on a single chromosome, that is X chromosome, X linked or not, what he identified in A cross. So this was according to A cross. In A cross, what he identified, that is a very, very important. What he identified, strong linkage between Y and W. What is that linkage? Now, take a chromosome 1, chromosome 2, X chromosome. So what are the genes? YY, WW. So this is a gene 1 concerned alleles, gene 2. Okay. So the distance between these two genes is very less. Distance. The distance between Y and W genes is very less. Okay, so according to his knowledge, that distance, what about the distance? Very less. Use better, very less. Very less. Okay, so very less according to our textbook. What about the distance given? The distance between called genes is 1.3 centimorgan. CM is a unit of measure used to measure the distance between two genes present on the same chromosome. Okay, so here Y and W genes are present on chromosome. They are with 1 centimorgan, not centimeter, centimorgan, CM, centimorgan units, unit of measure, centimorgan. So distance between those two genes is very less. So Y and W are, so conclusion one by one, Y and W are strongly linked. Y and W genes are with strong linkage. Strong linkage. For example, A and B friends. For example, only here I'm taking A and B friends, your classmates. In the month of first year, June, A and B, thick friends, eating together, reading together, doing everything together. Means the bond between A and B is very strong, not easy to break and not easy to cause separation. Okay? So first year A, B together, second year also almost more than half of second year also, academic year also A, B together, just before NEET exam, they separated. So A and B are strongly linked. The distance between those two, distance means they're very close to each other, not affected by crossing over, not easy to separate them. So in this case, if genes present on the same chromosome are strongly linked, if they are strongly linked, what about the conclusion made by Morgan? Statement one, conclusion out of a cross A. If they are strongly linked, if genes present on same chromosome are strongly linked, parental gene combinations, means parental type simply, parental progeny, progeny with a parental phenotype, parental gene combination, means simply I'm writing parental phenotype. Means progeny with a parental phenotype is far or more, is more greater than, more higher than its number higher than second one, non-parental gene combination, means phenotypic recombinants. So in this case, simply parental means parents more, parental phenotype more. So parental phenotype more recombinants less. Go back to textbook content. What about the percentage of parents? 98.7, I think. Okay, recombinants 1.3%. Okay, right? So here, it is not easy to measure the distance between Y and W. Not possible with a microscope or some other, but with the help of a phenotypic recombinant percentage. What about the percentage? 1.3. Come here. So what about the recombinants percentage? Recombinants percentage. How much? 1.3. So by using this percentage, we can measure, we can assess, we can predict the distance between Y and W. Okay, so recombination percentage is equal to distance between concerned genes, Y and W. What is that one? 1.3 centimorgan. 1% of recombination, the distance is 1 centimorgan. 1.3 recombination, 1.3 centimorgan. Okay. So with the help of a percentage of recombination, one could predict the distance between genes present on a chromosome. Okay. So Alfred Stativant, student of Morgan, used percentage of recombination as a unit of measure. Okay, so used percentage of recombination as a measure to decide the distance between genes present on the same chromosome. Okay, now compare this one with Mendel dihybrid cross. In Mendel dihybrid cross, what about the percentage of parent recombination? 62.5, recombinants 37.5. In the case of a dihybrid cross, here I'm writing. Take that one here. Dihybrid cross by Mendel. In that case, F2. In F2, what about the percentage of parents? Parents, parental percentage means parental phenotype. How much? That is a 62.5. Recombinants percentage, remaining one, how much? 37.5. Check it. How to get it? To get this one, 10 divided by 16 into 100, this one 6 divided by 16 into 100. Okay, so according to dihybrid cross, what about the distance between, according to Mendel, according to Morgan, if we compare that concept with a dihybrid cross, what about the distance between Y and R genes in pea plant is 37.5 centimorgan. Okay, so now Morgan is explaining, Mendel, in your concerned dihybrid cross, the distance between, on the base of percentage of recombinants, 37.5 recombinants, the distance between Y and R is 37.5 centimorgan. So that's why, what about the total number of recombinants, percentage appeared, percentage, take percentage, 37.5 means Y and R are less linked. The distance between those two is more than the distance between Y, W in A cross. So that's why in the case of A cross, what about the percentage of parents? 98.7. And recombinants 1.3 only. So that's why the phenotypic ratio of typical dihybrid cross, that is 9:3:3:1, was deviated. Deviated into, okay, 7, 1, 1, 7, nearest to that one. 7, 1, 1, 7. First 7, last 7. Parents, how many? 14. Recombinants, 2 only. Okay, so actually, almost the percentages are 15 and 1, like this. Okay, so roughly I'm giving. So what about the percent, according to the percent, 98.7 means almost 99%. Parents are not, 1.3 recombinants. So some other ratio, not according to this one, 7:1:1:7. Parent, 14, recombinants 2. Nearest to that percentage. Okay, so what was the explanation given by Morgan? In A cross, the distance between Y and W genes is very less. If genes are with a less distance, the distance between them is very less. The linkage is very strong, strongly linked, like relatives or friends, strongly linked. If they are strongly linked, rate of crossing over to separate them, segregate them is very less. Then what about the recombinants? Less number of recombinants are possible. So simply, if genes are strongly linked, what about the recombinants? Less number of recombinants, more number of parental combinations. Okay, right? Is it clear? So that is about A cross. After completion of A cross, he coined the term linkage. What is linkage? Physical association of genes present on the same chromosome. What is recombination? What is recombination? Used to explain variations available, phenotypic recombinants, variations present in the F2 generation. That is called as recombination. These two terms coined by Morgan. So that is about A cross, basic explanation. Okay, so now what about B cross basic explanation? We have to take that one also. So according to A cross, A was deviated from typical dihybrid cross conducted by Mendel. So out of A and B crosses, A shows a deviation or against a Mendel dihybrid cross. Now, what about a B cross? Okay. Now, dihybrid cross conclusion only, not entire cross. What about the conclusion out of this one? So, what about the genes he considered? What are the genes? Okay, so here. White, miniature. Wait. Sorry. WMM. Okay, so this is a gene one. W concern gene. This is a M gene. Gene 2. So according to Morgan, the distance between these two genes, statement one, the distance between these two genes. Wait, hang on. Distance between W and M genes present on same chromosome. Genes present on same chromosome, X chromosome. same X chromosome is according to percentage. What about the percentage of phenotypic recombinants? How much percentage? It is around 37.2. The distance with 37.2 centimorgan distance. So what about the percentage, 37.2 or not? Okay, so second statement, parental percentage, how much remaining? Around 62.8%. Third one, recombinants. Phenotypic recombinants. 37.2. So we can use percentage of recombination as a measure to calculate, to assess the distance between Y and W, 37.2. So if it is compared with A cross, what about the distance? Too much distance. So if the distance between concerned genes present on the same chromosome is more, what about the recombinants percentage? Increased or not? Increased. Not beyond 50%. Always a percentage of recombination is a 0 to 50%. Not more than that. Reason, each gene is with two alleles only, 50-50. So that's why maximum possibility for percentage of recombination is up to 50 only. 0 to 50%. More than 50% is not possible. Reason, each gene is with two alleles. First one, dihybrid cross by Mendel. So in the case of a Mendel, what about a parents percentage, recombinants percentage? Parents percentage, how much? Parental percentage, 62.5. Remaining how much? 37.5, check it. Yes. Next, this one. B dihybrid cross in Drosophila. Here, what about the percentage of parental and recombinants? 62.8. This one, 37.2. Almost same or not? Almost same. So B cross in the support of Mendel. But what about A cross? Now take A cross here or A cross there. A cross. Third statement, A cross. A dihybrid cross. A dihybrid cross. Parental combinations. 98.7, recombinants 1.3. Okay, so 1 and 2 concerned genes are less linked, but what about A cross? Strong linkage. So that's why, what about the percentage of recombinants? 1.3. Okay, so A shows a deviation from dihybrid cross, B was in the support of dihybrid cross. So A cross is against the law of independent assortment proposed by Mendel. Reason, in the case of dihybrid cross conducted by Mendel, Y and R genes are present on different chromosomes. Use that statement that was given. Okay, so A cross is against the law of independent assortment, but B was in the support of a law of independent assortment proposed by Mendel. Okay, right? So actually, what was the target of Morgan? experimental verification of chromosomal theory of inheritance. What he discovered one by one. First one, he discovered reasons for variations caused by sexual reproduction. Second one, linkage and recombination. Linkage and recombination. Next, against independent assortment, in the support of independent assortment also. Okay, so that is about Morgan experiments on Drosophila, dihybrid cross A and B.